up over the last 4 years alone, 30% in chlamydia, 70% in gonorrhea, and we've doubled the rate of syphilis.
Oof. Sex, lies, and STDs. Gina Silva takes a special look at how to protect yourself in a dating app world. It is the dark side of the digital hookup culture. People lying about their STDs, and for many, the diagnosis isn't so simple. Gina Silva talked to experts about what you can do to protect yourself before you swipe right.
From Tinder to Grindr, dozens of dating apps make it easy to engage in a quick sexual hookup. The result, according to some experts, an alarming spike in STDs, sexually transmitted diseases.
People have many more hookups today than they did in the past. And you know, the public health system can't follow, because a lot of times people have hookups, they don't even know the last name of their partner or where their home is, so they can't even notify them, even if they wanted to, that they have an STD.
Dr. Robert Huizenga is an associate professor at UCLA and the author of Sex, Lies, and STDs.
There's a dramatic rise in STDs. I mean, we're up over the last 4 years alone, 30% in chlamydia, 70% in gonorrhea, and we've doubled the rate of syphilis. Syphilis is a disease we essentially cured in the 1950s.
But syphilis has come back with a vengeance. Infection rates are at the highest in 20 years. In California, 250,000 STDs were reported last year alone. Locally, Long Beach had the second highest rates of gonorrhea and the third highest rates of syphilis in the entire state. Dr. Huizenga says part of the problem is the lack of education.
We have to understand that condoms are great, but they only can prevent probably 60 or 70% of all STDs.
And some diseases can be transmitted without even having sex.
That could be HPV, and that could be herpes, and sometimes even things like syphilis you can get with kissing.
During this year's Coachella and Stagecoach festivals, the online diagnosis and treatment app called Herp Alert claimed there was a massive herpes outbreak in that area. They said people attending the festivals were even uploading photos of their sores in order to get prescription medications within 2 hours. Ricky Rocket, seen here in this YouTube video, is the drummer of the mega band Poison, with 45 million albums sold and tours around the world.
The early days were crazy, and I think we learned pretty early on that condoms, for one thing, and ID.
Rocket says life constantly on the road meant meeting lots of different women.
Everything comes fast. That can lead to problems.
Many years after his rock and roll lifestyle, Rocket discovered he had HPV, a common sexually transmitted infection. In Rocket's case, it caused cancer.
My body may have cleared it years before, but it created a mutation, and that mutation became cancerous.
Thanks to chemo and immunotherapy, Rocket has been cancer-free for 3 years. Dr. Huizenga is one of his doctors. Now they're both trying to educate people on the dangers of HPV and other sexually transmitted diseases.
People lie about certain STDs. We need to just drop the curtain and go, hey, look, it's just like I have a cold, I'm not going to give you a kiss right now. You know, because I don't want you to get sick.
To prevent HPV, kids as young as 13 can be vaccinated against it. And
we should give this vaccine all the way up until the 50s, especially for people, say, coming off of a long relationship where they really haven't had much recent exposure.
Some dating sites are addressing the rise in STDs. Tinder has added a health safety section urging people to protect their health. Grindr now has an option for users to add their HIV status on their profiles. While that's a good start, Dr. Huizenga says we all need to understand that we're dealing with a massive problem.
We're in the middle of an epidemic, and you know, all the rest of us Americans are to blame too, because we're grossly undereducated.
He says the best thing anyone can do for their health is talk openly about STDs, practice safe sex, be in a mutual monogamous relationship, and most importantly, get tested on a regular basis.
This is such a stigmatized field. People are like, I don't want to read about it. If I get a symptom, I'll go online. Too late. Get the knowledge beforehand.
Gina Silva, Fox 11 News.
Oh, it's scary, right? But it's important to talk about it, like you said.
How excited are you to be married right now?
the monogamous relationship they just talked about? They just talked
about it. I mean, syphilis through kissing?
I didn't know about that either.
Oh, man. Yeah. Thankful to that rock star for speaking out, though. I mean, it's brave of him to speak out.
I would say so, yeah. For sure, for sure. And I think that they make a good point that the more we talk about it, the more we understand it, and the more we accept people going in to get treatment and being open.
Fascinating story. All right, thank you to Gina.